Good afternoon. Good afternoon to my fellow speakers, esteemed delegates and chair here. Maybe I wasn't at the end in the list, but somehow I landed up at the end. So I know everyone's spirit and interest after lunch, but bear with me, I would not take much time and I would not try to bore you with so much of uninteresting topics. So I want to talk about process plant digital solutions, and I think the session has been restricted to people and process safety, and a lot have been told about people and process safety by my fellow speakers and previous sessions as well. So I would restrict only to topics or implemented case studies of whatever has been done by L&T Technology Services. Before I jump to that, I would take you through the overall bouquet of solutions that are possible for plant operation. I am not going to touch upon each of them because each of these is going to be a one-day session on that. So you can see productivity improvement, energy, water management, regulatory compliance, safety, quality compliance, and OPEX and maintenance cost reductions. So what I wanted to say is we work on, in fact, as my role into implementation of digital solutions across multiple industry verticals in chemical, oil and gas, we have been able to implement multiple digital solutions here, and right from OPEX improvements, energy, water management, and all based on, matching the theme of this session, like breaking the barrier. So what is that? In each of these digital solutions, we are trying to ensure that the information flow is seamless across the supply chain of an organization and across the control hierarchies. So you have a vertical seamless flow of information and horizontal seamless flow of information, and you have got one instance of truth that comes out right from the sensors from where you get it. And when that is captured in each of these, and then you build upon various solutions to implement this, then you get a better solution here. So now let me only focus on the safety part here. I would focus on the worker safety and monitoring solutions and implemented case study here. So before we start, Mr. Badal talked about how difficult it is to ensure safe situations when the worker's behavior is not in control. And he talked of statistics, 98% of hazards are because of behavioral aspects and 2% are because of equipment. I am trying to portray here a small solution which might try to track the behavioral part of a worker and how do you ensure that the workers are wearing the right kind of PPEs or the personal protective equipments which are issued to them. So every worker which joins an organization, he is issued the right kind of PPE, the authorization or permit to get into the right kind of areas where he is allowed to go. But problem comes when the person doesn't use that. And, that is a behavioral part. How do you ensure without having a lot of intrusive applications or intrusive devices built into each and every PPE, how do you ensure that the person is using the right kind of equipment? So here comes the solution which is implemented in a US customer, a chemical plant customer, where the solution is using the existing CCTV camera setup of a plant. No new cameras are used. The existing CCTV camera, the digital feed of that is taken into from these cameras taken into the security establishment, and an application is built using Microsoft Azure, cognitive technologies, and various other tensor based machine learning technologies. And what it does is it recognizes the image of the worker, and then from a database correlates it with what kind of a equipment and PPEs are issued to this worker, and then what kind of skill that person is there, and whether he is wearing that, because this particular video analysis is actually segmenting each and every portion of the video and identifying whether it is, whether the particular helmet is there in place, whether the right gloves are there in place, and you know, then gives a message and gives an automatic alert to the supervisor and alert to the person, and then it is captured as a safety violation. And many, that organization where it has been introduced, a 3-time safety violation is considered as immediate administrative actions will be taken for the person. On a 4th violation, you'll be debarred from getting into the plant. So the moment the workers know that they are being watched, whether they are wearing the right kind of equipment, immediately the behavioral pattern is, you know, immediately improved from that. So this application, you can, that was in an on-premise application. It was within the premise of it. There are options available to take it to cloud, and there are going to be multiple plants also. You'll be able to see what kind of safety violations are there. Next, I would move to another worker safety monitoring in a chemical plant and in a construction site. In fact, the construction site is L&T's own construction site, where some 25,000 workers were involved in multiple areas, spread across a huge area. And the chemical plant is a US a chemical customer here. So both the solutions put together into one of these slides here. So what it has been done here is that each and every person is provided with a wearable. It's a band. It's not a watch, like my colleague said in the previous. It is a specially developed small band, and which works on these 3-4 technologies. RFID based technology was there in the construction site, in the chemical plant, whereas you have a UWB, you know, ultra wideband technology of wireless technology was there for construction site in L&T's here. And what happens is, the moment the worker comes to the construction site or plant, then his presence is registered when he is issued that wearable. They are supposed to submit the wearables there. See, what happens is, in a construction site, it's not an office, and it's, everything is open. Makeshift arrangements are there. You have trailers, or you have multiple different temporary sheds are there, where you cannot have a full-fledged office setup. So a lot of activities used to be there, which are log-based or manual-based systems. So these wearables really helped, so that active tag or active band will be issued to the worker at the time he enters there. Now that helps in planning. So you have some 15,000 workers have been planned today, and how many people have joined, and you know where they are currently. And then that tag also gives information about the complete location, where the worker is there, at what location, and whether they are moving. And it also has a panic button, like many of the applications. So if he is in a dangerous situation, in case of an evacuation requirement, he can press that and his location can be identified and he can be taken out. And this has been the implemented case studies here. So these are the two things I wanted to touch upon. Moving on to process safety management, my colleague has already talked about in detail about how do you do it, process safety management here. And Mr. Badal Roy also talked about, we do a lot of process safety management, and it's a given thing, it's done. It is part of detail engineering work. So when I or my team of instrumentation and process engineers, we implement a project for any kind of oil and gas chemical customers, of course, HAZOP and hazard analysis is part of a detail basic engineering job, extended into detail engineering part as well. And those are done. And that is taken care. But what I'm talking here, a difference wanted to bring here, is a overall or a comprehensive process safety management. Doing for a particular customer, where not only the detail engineering documents is carried out or identification of hazards are done, but over a period of time, complete process safety cycle management is also done. After the process safety, after the hazards are done, after the records are created, where do they reside? Where do they stay? If I go further here, so complete, if you see the 3 levels here, you know, building up of foundation is a regular process safety identification, HAZOP and hazard as per, I know, IEC 61508 standards, governing all the hazards and all. So you do all those calculations. You do put into the engineering controls, you put into the administrative controls. All those things are carried out, those documentations are there. But building upon that, when you have small modifications coming up in the plant, how do you manage them over a period of time? Where the records are being kept? When there is a issue happened in your previous project, how is it been handled? What are the lessons learned for each of these process safety things? So all are also kept, and if you look at, there is a process safety information governance. So process safety information governance is what the new I wanted to bring it here. So this is one digital platform where you have all process safety information right from the detail engineering onwards to management of change, what he talks about, all records. So those are SORs, safety of records. So you have safety records or non-safety records, all are captured together and they are available readily on tip of everyone. It's a portal-based system which you can have. So there are, the implemented case study is with a documentum-based system where you have all safety records are kept. There is another case study where you have the system available as a safety portal where you can capture based on authorization of the person, you can find out what was the past record, what is the current status of various process safety management area. This is one case study with documentation where with a documentum system where you have all safety records are kept there. Well, I know this session is on safety part, but I wanted to take this opportunity for operational excellence, and I wanted to talk about some implemented case studies of OPEX optimization. And one of the things is for our own L&T valve. So this is a huge valve for oil and gas where we have for our L&T valve manufacturing. So this is the valve currently, actually the model is out as well. So where we implemented the systems basically for leak detection. So what happens in
sorry
the maintenance
to interrupt,
area?
Sorry, Mr. Rath, two minutes for you.
Oh, I have 2 minutes. Okay, sorry, I'll quickly go. So so this is an intrusive implementation where leak detection and other sensors are built into, but we offer also, we have implemented solutions where existing valves and systems, we can have snap-on type, non-intrusive type sensors to capture data. Next is a predictive maintenance solution. This is our own L&T solutions where we have an edge gateway, which is a wireless edge gateway where in the existing plant, you don't have to completely change a compressor or a conveyor or a huge equipment. What you have to do is there are snap-on type sensors, vibration sensors, temperature sensors, which can be mounted there. They will communicate to an edge gateway, and then what is different here is analytics is built into that, and what we do is we take the information of the pump. So for example, there is a pump, you have a pump curve, and that pump curve is built into the analytics. So you have got 80% of your predictions already built into that, and over a period of time, it is going to learn and it is going to improve upon those predictions and all. It's going to exactly tell when it is going to fail and what actions need to be taken. That helps a lot in terms of your maintenance shutdown and all. So another part is what energy management solution. So there are, I think some previous sessions talked about how do you do it, energy management here. So what we talk about here is we carry out an audit of energy conservation and audit and what is the AG scenario of energy metering solutions there. So in the plant, first of all, in most of the plants, energy meters will not be available, or there will not be flow meters available to calculate the gas or water flow. So first, identification of where you want to measure, because the moment you see only, you will be able to act on that. So an audit is carried out, and energy conservation measures also there put into place, and the recommendations were given. On top of that, we provide a solution in app-based solutions, where you will be able to see exactly what is the consumption pattern of water, air, gas, electricity. We call it a wages solution. So this is implemented at some 11 different sites across the globe with one of our customers. And there are three different other customers on implementation here. So you have right from level zero of automation to you know, level 4 of automation where all information are available. So this is what the company I represent with L&T Technology Services, which is part of L&T, catering to all industry verticals here. Thank you.